A resource-based economy is simply the scientific method applied to social concern, an approach utterly absent in the world today. Society is a technical invention, and the most efficient methods of optimized human health, physical production, distribution, city infrastructure, and the like reside in the field of science and technology, not politics or monetary economics. It operates in the same systematic way as, say, an airplane, and there is no Republican or liberal way to build an airplane. Likewise, nature itself is the physical referent we use to prove our science, and it is a set system, emerging only from our increased understanding of it. In fact, it has no regard for what you subjectively think or believe to be true. Rather, it gives you an option. You can learn and fall in line with its natural laws and conduct yourself accordingly, invariably creating good health and sustainability. Or you can go against the current, to no avail. It doesn't matter how much you believe you can just stand up right now and walk on the wall next to you. The law of gravity will not allow it. If you do not eat, you will die. If you are not touched as an infant, you will die. As harsh as it may sound, nature is a dictatorship, and we can either listen to it and come in harmony with it, or suffer the inevitable adverse consequences. So, a resource-based economy is nothing more than a set of proven, life-supporting understandings where all decisions are based upon optimized human and environmental sustainability. It takes into account the empirical life ground, which every human being shares as a need, regardless, again, of their political or religious philosophy. There is no cultural relativism to this approach. It isn't a matter of opinion. Human needs are human needs, and having access to the necessities of life, such as clean air, nutritious food, and clean water, along with a positively reinforcing, stable, nurturing, and non-violent environment, is demanded for our mental and physical health, our evolutionary fitness, and hence the species' survival itself.
A resource-based economy would be based upon available resources. You can't just bring a lot of people to an island or build a city of 50,000 people without having access to the necessities of life. So when I use the term a comprehensive systems approach, I'm talking about doing an inventory of the area first and determining what that area can supply, not just architectural approach, not just design approach, but design must be based on all of the requirements to enhance human life. And that's what I mean by an integrated way of thinking. Food, clothing, shelter, warmth, love, all those things are necessary. If you deprive people of any of them, you have a lesser human being, less capable of functioning.
As previously outlined, a resource-based economy's ground-up, global, systems approach to extraction, production, and distribution is based upon a set of true economic mechanisms, or strategies, which guarantee efficiency and sustainability in every area of the economy.